Ahoy, today's dispatch is about getting around Okayama by various means, particularly getting to the various events related to the wedding. Keep in mind I'm putting together some little welcome packets for you with some maps and brochures and some other instructions, so you don't have to memorize all of this, but it's a good idea to kind of familiarize yourself with what's where and all that kind of stuff. First of all, you'll notice by the arrow is the Okayama station to kind of orient yourself, plus those little X's are the hotels where folks are generally staying. Whereas the circles are the two main places that you need to know about, the shrine and then the restaurant for the fancy lunch after the ceremony. But before I get into the details of that, a few notes about where to get more answers, because invariably you're going to have questions. If you go down to the first floor of Okayama train station, you'll find the Momotaro Tourist Information Center. I've gone in there and collected some maps and some other resources that I'll hand off to you. And I also warned them that around April 20th and so, there's going to be a whole gaggle of renegade foreigners showing up here. So, yoroshiku onegaishimasu. Please look after them. To find the Tourist Information Center, just go down the escalator out front of the main exit entrance of the station and follow the signs. Now, keep in mind that the station is the hub of life and all this kind of thing in Japanese cities, so you'll also find handy things like coin lockers to stash your backpack if you want to go out for a stroll, all kinds of restaurants with food, example food that looks good enough to eat, and even you can get yourself a bottle of Japanese first craft brewery. These sort of subterranean shopping hallways connect to other malls, the big Aeon Mall Plaza, which is filled with all kinds of stores and restaurants and that kind of stuff, plus all kinds of other services, so a good place to regroup. Plus, you'll notice signs to get to the streetcars and other transportation networks. These streetcars are super handy, and some of them are even kind of real old-timey vintage. The stations, the stops, are in the middle of the road, but the great thing is you can get around town for 100 yen, so about a dollar, and it takes you to most of the main tourist places, and it'll be a real handy way for you to get around town. Besides the super handy streetcars, there's a couple different kinds of buses. First of all, there's these short green tourist buses that, again, are 100 yen and will run on a couple different routes that are kind of designed for tourists. Like, we'll take you from the station to the castle and the park and that kind of thing. As far as regular old city buses, it gets a little bit confusing because, well, they're not really designed for tourists so much, but also there's four different bus companies, privatized bus companies operating in the area. But if you're handy with Google Maps and directions and stuff, you can certainly make it happen. There's lots of signage, but generally it's written in Japanese, so you have to look it up in Google Maps and kind of mix and match the characters as best you can. But it's a nice fallback plan if you need it. Oh, and here's a bonus shot of a bus and someone's hotel, the APA Ekimai Hotel. All right, as you're strolling around town, you'll notice a lot of fresh new signs with glued on Romaji ABC characters to make your life a little bit easier, taking you to most of the common sites, the Korakuen Garden, the various prefectural offices, and the castle, and that kind of stuff. You'll see map displays, various kiosks, signages of all kinds of different types, and you'll find that downtown Okayama is quite walkable, so a lot of your exploring can really be done on foot. If you get a little tired, then hop a streetcar. There are also taxis, of course, and the good news about taxis is they know where they're going. The bad news is they usually won't be able to understand your English. The good news is they will never rip you off. You don't even have to open the doors. Do not even try to open the doors. The doors will open automatically, close automatically. The driver will actually help you with your luggage if you have such a thing. The other downside is they can get a little bit expensive, but there are going to be a few times throughout this trip where you're going to need to use a taxi. For the most part, you can have the hotel call a taxi for you. If you need a taxi and you're not at the hotel, just look for one of these taxi stand stations, or you'll see taxis cruising, but generally hanging out around the station or these taxi stands is your best bet. We'll also include a little guide in that welcome packet to show the taxi driver that says, please take me to blah 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 place in Japanese to make it easier. Cool. You'll notice Japanese folks on bicycles everywhere, somehow surviving without helmets. Oh my goodness. And you'll see these green bike docks. Now, I looked into this, and it's a colossal pain to get registered. To rent them, you need to have a Japanese cell phone number for verification. So while you won't be able to rent one of these dockable green bikes, there's all sorts of bike rentals around, including one right in the train station that rents bikes for 350 yen, So $3-4 a day. Apparently, some of the JR passes include free bike rental. I haven't done this before, so your mileage may vary, but it's something to keep in mind. Free bike rental, JR train pass. All right, there you have it, a few different methods for getting around your new tiny universe of Okayama. One other note about the buses and streetcar is you board using what we would consider the back door. In the case of the buses, you take a ticket which will have a number on it. The amount you pay when you disembark is based on how far you've traveled. It sounds a little confusing. You may not run into this anyway. In the case of the streetcars or the green tourist buses, 100 yen. There's just a couple routes of each one, and I'll try and include those in your welcome packet. Taxis are all around and they're super fancy and won't rip you off, but they're a little bit expensive. In the next video, we'll discuss how to get to the shrine and how to get to the restaurant and how to get to the farm, which will be the three scenes of festivities as you come to Okayama.